Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. We are from HE20. We would like to present about managerial analysis for Astro Malaysian Holding Berhad. Astro Malaysian Holding Berhad is a Malaysian and ASEAN digital first media lifestyle company in the digital TV, radio and e-commerce space. It was bought formally in Sunday, 29 September 1996, and launched. The first name is Philip Astro, and then the administration building of Astro is in the central city of Malaysia in Kuala Lumpur, and the total of their employees is around 4,456 people. Okay, for the first step in the managerial analysis is organize. So for Astro company, they use a traditional hierarchy, which is the board director of the company will give the direction to the chief executive officer. So the chief executive officer will give separate the direction or the works, the job to the other manager in the company. So in a making decision, they do a lot about making decisions. A few is always take customer feedback and do some improvement on that. So it means they always make improvement based on the customer feedback. So it will attract the customer and then the customer will always increase over the times. And the second is do corporate responsibility to the people and environment. So as a company, Astro company, they always do a corporate responsibility, help the people, the public, and also the environment, and then cooperate with a few company for make more marketing in their product, which is have collaborate with some company and make more marketing about their product, and also for the investment, which for add on a lot of investor to their company. So that's it to me. Thank you.
Okay, I am Aisha Farhana. So planning is a primary management function which consists of a vision, mission and SWOT analysis. So Astro's vision is to create an organization that will exceed customers' expectation in quality, on-time delivery, problem solving, service and cost control. Next is mission. Their mission is to make the best effort to promote from within and help employees to achieve their full potential through continuous education, training and recognition of performance. Next is SWOT analysis. So SWOT stands for strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats. For the strengths, since Astro is the leading media company, they have a huge strength in marketing. They can broadcast any advertisement across their channels, and this will result to a high number of views. So they can expand their business from this marketing strategy. Next is weakness. Although Astro is an established company, they still have some weakness such as delayed broadcast, especially during rainy days. Besides that, they also have been receiving many complaints on repeating shows, and some customers can't access into broadcast. The third one is opportunities. Astro have huge opportunities as a leading media company since Malaysia have is having a lack of media company. They also have a variety TV shows, and this will make their customers to this will be an attraction for their customers. The last one is threats. Astro have some threats such as competitors. For an example, their competitor is Enjoy, which serve a similar nature of business, and then they also have been receiving a lot of complaints on high service charge from their customer. Okay, that's all for planning. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Nurajan Ali binti Anwar. As for leadership, we have three types of leadership styles, which is first, democratic styles, autocratic styles, and the last one is laissez-faire styles. As for democratic styles, it is referred to when the managers and the employees are working together to make a decision. While for autocratic style is when making manager decisions without consult others, such as their teammates or subordinates. As for laissez-faire style, it is when the managers provide a way on how to work things done for their employees. As for leader style for Astro, we have three leaders, which is the first one is Dato' Rohana Rozhan, which is the CEO and a group CEO. The second one is Dato' Jack Abdullah, which is the CEO of Astro Radio. And the third one is the Henry Tan, which is the Chief Operating Officer. As for Dato' Rohana Rozhan, under her leadership, she is using to empowering her employees. In order to drive and sustain a high performance of workforce, employee achievements will appraised. As for Dato' Jack Abdullah, he likes to work with teams so that the way he treat his worker is by encourage them to take an action to achieve a goal. As for the last one, for Henry Tan, he will see their staff work first and then he will evaluate them on how to improve in the future.
I'm Indira. Today I want to present about controlling. Control or controlling is one of the managerial functions like planning, organizing, staffing and directing. Control in management means setting standards, measuring actual performance and taking corrective action. For Astro, with controlling, Astro have reached their target. Firstly, there are three controlling stands from three main procedure. That is, the first one will be estimating genuine execution. The second one is think about the real execution against a standard. The third one is making an administrative move. As for Astro, Astro is have a producer of vernacular, that is has considered Asians unique multi-language gathering. They have made 12,000 hours with FY17. That is the main of the media for the Astro. Other than that, Astro have won the gold respect in the media and entertainment for the world first class for the entertainment series. Then it also have a Putra Brand Award as far back as 6 years, including Brand of Years in 2012 and Brand Icon in 2013. From the controlling part, that is we can see it from the financial statement of Astro, that we can get it from the annual report of the Astro. That is, the financial statement show us that the increase in their profit and the revenue of the Astro. From there, we can know that the controlling procedure has been used very well by the Astro Holdings. That's all from me. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Siti Mustafa. So, to conclude our presentation, for us, Astro is a good company as they keep on improving their performance and try to reach their customers' expectations. Besides, they are being responsible for their employees by providing them various trainings to enhance their skills, such as leadership, and encourage their employees to give feedback regarding their working experience in Astro Malaysia Holdings Berhad. Our recommendation towards Astro is they should further their company, they should further their wings to international level, as they have potential in both management and financial perspective. So that's all from me. Thank you.